So, since part one was just on the Perfect Great Strike itself and what came out in 2004, part two was on the Ale Pack and what came with the Sky Grasper, we can now get into the new stuff, and we're gonna start with the Launcher Pack. But I do want to say something beforehand. I'm an idiot. I, for some reason, thought that the Perfect Grade Original Strike didn't have the shield and the beam rifle. I'm dumb. I couldn't remember, and I went online and I saw pictures of the Sky Grasper with the shield and the rifle on, and I just thought for some reason it came with them. If I was smart, I would have looked at the instructions and then seen the plates with the red parts for the strike and the red part for the shield on the same plate. Right there it shows. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm sorry. I wish I could go back and fix it, or at least use an annotation if YouTube still use those, but I can't. So yes, I'm dumb. I said the wrong thing. But I mean, it's in the past now. But I do admit I was stupid. So we'll start with the backpack, which it was pretty good. I like the pens. I love the clear blue in the top here. It's definitely different. You do have a ball joint here at the base. You have two tabs that hold the arm together with the launcher. Now the thing is, the weight of the launcher is still a little too much, and it does untap a little too easily. But it tries. So you have a hinge here, rotation, and then a double hinge out where the cannon goes. And to connect it, just put in the same port as the ale pack. And I forgot about this. What is that for? I don't really know. The original did that, so I'm not really sure the justification for that, but it doesn't. But anyways, there it is on the back. Now, the actual launcher itself is very nice, very big. Nicely detailed. These yellow parts open up for some reason. It's different. I like it. You got some clear on the cannon. Got the main handle here. Got the extra one. Now I love the fact that they're integrating with the strike and the sword and launch pack. They're integrating the energy containers from the Perfect Strike. So they're telling us that like it's always used these kind of energy containers, and the Perfect Strike just has more of them. The last longer, and it makes sense. So you just have to open up some pieces to get it out. The side ones really don't do anything, but they just kind of keep it from wiggling some. It's really these ones here that clamp down. So yeah, I like that. It's very nice. Now I'm gonna, since I have the third party, slightly upgraded, but 160 parts from the old no grade 160 strike. I'm gonna show them off. So here it is next to the no grade one. I like the darker green. You have the clear, of course. Still got a handle here, but this one actually opens up, like it extends. I like that better. Yeah. I mean, see the details there on the back, but here it is here. So it does look like an energy container. Just in the color, just was more detail, but you can see what they were going for. So I definitely like that. And it has a big socket there, so it'll just connect. Once you have that on, like I said, the tabs have a little harder time keeping them on. Everything hooked up. Now finally, the shoulder piece, which has the movable shoulder shields. You have the missiles there. It has some red detail on the back. And then the Gatling gun, I guess it is. It does rotate, but it's very easy to untap it from the yellow. It comes off way too easy, I find. And it's a little wobbly. So it's not the best connection. You might want to glue it, but it works. It does its thing, I guess. Now the old one right here, rather different, especially in the Gatling gun department. Like way smaller there. It's a lot tinier. Even this is slightly enlarged to match with the perfect grade size. You can see how different it is. I like the darker green on all this. All the detail is there, pretty much. Actually, they've had more vents here. But yeah, just way better, of course, because it's a perfect grade. Now, unfortunately, it's not just a matter of what we would have expected back in the day of opening the armor here, pulling out this plug, and plopping it on. You actually have to use an adapter, which is a little annoying. Put it just pegs on, close around it, and you have four corresponding holes which will plug in. So it's not a simple plug and play, but hey, it's not terrible. And there is the perfect grade launcher strike. And I really like it. I like all the new detail on it. I do like the longer galley gun, even though it's a pain to keep on. The actual launcher itself is nice and big, has a lot more detail. I love the energy adapter piece. Now, having the model hold it, you can use the normal fully articulated hands. They will wrap around. But with this kit, they give you specific non-articulated holding hands, which are different. This one here, for the larger side, is essentially a normal non-articulated holding hand with a ball joint. It just comes apart. There's no tab or anything inside it. And so, yeah, it's not hard for these to come off the sockets. Yeah, once you get it all around, use the main handle. Like I said, these will wrap around and hold. They'll do the job well enough, but if you want it to be super secure. And I noticed, even though this looks like a hole for the tab in the hand, it doesn't work. You've got tried. It's especially the plastic, so that doesn't really work. Those tab holes are not made for the actual tabs, they're just detailing us. So, just gonna connect it like that. It's easier, I think, to do it off the body, just because of all the joints. It's just gonna keep popping out the cannon, so I just do it separately. And then just get the arm up there to match. Which can be a little tricky, but it can be done. And then it'd be a better job to use the actual articulated hands holding this handle if you want to. And you do have to swap the hand covers. There's only one set, so you have to take them off the articulate and put them on the static hands. But it does work. That was really good. Just stand like that with the cannon at the side. I really do like that. It's very cool. And once again, since I have the slightly blown up old 160 scale, I will compare the new perfect grade launcher strike with the perfect grade strike with the slightly oversized third party 160 scale launcher pack. So you can see the drastic difference with the parts, how these ones look like toys pretty much, and these look like the model version. So now that we've done those, we can get on to the sword pack.